Hey guys, it's Poker Pers and welcome back to my favorite 16 a little poker on my world. Last time I left off, I was ultra fuming that I dropped 2 points already in the league and have fallen behind in the league. If you didn't see my last episode, go watch it. Warning, I'm not gonna admit, but I did get very, very frustrated. But I'm not gonna let that affect me. I'm gonna go out here, play these games today, and see up. First up, I have a Capital One Cup game against Portsmouth. So, I don't want to take my frustrations out on Portsmouth. They didn't have anything to do with it. I do want to beat Portsmouth. That's the whole point of a competition, is, you know, you have to beat who the game puts in front of you. But, you know, I'm not going to embarrass them. My frustrations in the last episode, last episode, shouldn't be taken out on Portsmouth. They had nothing.
Stability, and if you're front four, as you might describe them, good players, it's a really potent system.
It took me a few days, but I calmed down.
4-4-2, but an interesting variation on it.
Yeah, a little diamond in midfield, and I wouldn't be surprised at some point if it's not working.
So I can focus on
the cross comes in now.
Making sure that what caused me to get angry in the last episode doesn't happen. So let's get to work. Come on, show you can get there. Brilliant. I'll take the throw.
Well, the ball's been deflected out, so it'll be a throw in.
Turbay. Whoops it in. Where you can't get there. Merchant off the post. Oh, what a goal that would have been. Freaking bicycle kick. Kick a standard one. Not the football style one. Where you have to. That's what. A different kind of bicycle kick, but that would have been a fantastic goal, not gonna lie. Really, you got that hit the post. Good job, Sanchez. I can see a big future for this Sanchez kid. As a defender for the club for a while, for years to come. Oh yes, Costa! Finally gets the breakthrough.
Cool. It's come in from a long way out, and from that angle, it's not always easy to finish.
Defender's caught out by it in the end.
Well, it's the anticipation as well. Wasn't
keeper tried. He did get a hand to it, but he couldn't keep it out. And Martin Costa opens the score. 1-0.
Decision is a throw. It was a fair tackle.
The tackle by Iheanacho at the expense of a throw of Portsmouth. Collins. Straight back to me. Alright, go on, Jordan. Go on, Jordan. Oh, he avoids the challenge like a boss. And the cross is terrible. I was trying to pass it backwards, and the game just, you know, just one lesson.
Kyle Bennett.
I'm so glad it's almost that time of the year where we get the new FIFA. Hopefully they've corrected this passing crap. And I know I'm not the only one who's noticed that their passes go straight.
Very good. Intercepting play there, to get his positional situation right and win the ball without too much effort.
Man, I'm as... Oh, cool. Holy shit, the random pass, because you never know who, whether it'll pass it to who you want it to pass it to, or someone you don't want it to pass it to. Chances are probably who you don't want it to go to.
Iturbe.
Hey, that's a free out. Come on, ref.
At the moment, it's looking quite good for Liverpool.
Never mind. Go on, Jordan. Run, Jordan, run.
As we look towards the clock at time approaching.
Turn. Leave the defender in his place. Yes. It's her way. Come on, give me the opening. Give me the opening. Jordan Ibe. Oh, brilliant. The move started by Jordan Ibe is finished by Jordan Ibe. Fantastic.
And that has just lasered into the corner. Unstoppable.
This game of patience was started by Jordan Ibe when he picked up the ball.
Viewpoint on it.
Oh. Well, in my own half. The run and the patience. That was an attack perfectionalized. As a hell way to score your first goal of the season for young Jordan Ibe.
Just widen the margin here to
2-0 just before halftime. That is perfect. Gives me a decent lead to go in to a halftime. And there's a halftime whistle right on the cue. And it also gives me a decent lead to improve on in the second half. A few Premier League teams playing, like West Brom, who Liverpool have in their last league game on Sunday. After the, I won't lie, disappointing game against Chelsea. I know we did get the equaliser, but Chelsea should have beaten us hands down. And I'm not gonna lie. And Everton, who I just learned actually before I started recording, has sacked Roberto Martinez.
Yes. Good action in the English League Cup in the first 45 minutes. Second half starts now.
I think one or two players surprised us actually.
I went in. I had Sky Sports News on to keep a listen out for any news of Blue.
Very good stop here.
You go into check, and I see Everton sack Martinez. This is from Sky's sources, and I'm like, what? Although, to be fair, I think Everton fans will tell you this sacking has been really, it's been coming for a while. How he wasn't sacked way earlier than this is an absolute mystery. I think it's because of how far they got in the Capital One and FA Cups, but all in all, Everton have been really poor this season, and they haven't got the excuse of the Europa League to fall back on, like they did last season. Everton have been poor to the point where I could see them honestly going down this season. If they play like they have in the last, for the last good while. I mean, I don't know that many Everton fans, but
as it turned out,
from watching Everton's poor performances against the likes of Sunderland, Liverpool, and Leicester, I could just see Everton have just fallen apart. And I think, not just Everton fans, I think everyone has noticed this. The question now is, who takes over the Everton job? I mean, longtime Everton manager David Moyes is currently at work. Could a return for him be on the card? Will they go for something new? I guess we'll have to wait and see. And if David Moyes was to return, would that mean he'd go back for Marouane Fellaini? And will the cycle be complete? Yeah. So, Everton are down a manager. And the Premier League are down. Who knows? Canaries and Tunes. I've talked about the game between Sunderland and Everton last night. That confirmed the relegation of both Norwich, despite their victory over Watford, and Newcastle, who really, they may as well have been relegated as soon as they didn't get the job done against Aston Villa. I think all Newcastle fans were just waiting for it. I think they knew from the moment they saw that result, and the fact that Sunderland beat Chelsea, I think that was the final nail in the Newcastle coffin, because I don't think there was anyone who would have put money on Everton to beat Sunderland last night. Not with the way Everton have been playing, and not with the hunger that you can see in Sunderland recently, especially with them game wins. And important wins that have led to them surviving in the Premier League. Reed, they made a great appointment. Sunderland made a great appointment in terms of who they brought in to replace Alcott when he quit back in November.
He might be through. Shots on here.
They got Sam Allardyce, who is so good at surviving. He is like the ultimate Premier League manager survivor. Like, a lot of managers get credit for how long they survived in the Premier League. Managers like Tony Pulis, this who kept Stoke as a solid Premier League team ever since they came up. They have been down. I think everyone was originally expecting Stoke to go straight back down, but Tuan Pulis made them into the almost regular Premier League team that they are now.
No, I think their manager.
You could say he's doing the same with West Brom.
This is an opportunity. When you concede a free kick in an area like this, you could be in serious trouble.
Couldn't keep it down.
And that was a terrible free kick. All in all, I think Sam Allardyce is one of, if not the greatest manager in terms of survival out there. Newcastle, I'm not going to diss Newcastle. I think everyone can agree, if he had more time, I think Rafa Benitez would have saved Newcastle if he had more time. But the appointment was made too late, and even Newcastle fans have pointed this out. I've heard Newcastle YouTuber The True Joe, he made this a few times since the appointment was made, that the appointment might be too late. And sure enough, the damage was done by Steve McLaren. The damage was too much. Newcastle, despite having Rafa Benitez, couldn't save their season from ending in relegation, and they'll be playing in the championship next season. Just one of those things, isn't it? I don't know when Newcastle might even come up. I don't. They're gonna need a serious rebuilding job. Newcastle could experience something like a Middlesbrough. Middlesbrough, who are returning to the Premier League next season, ironically pretty much in place of Newcastle, considering Middlesbrough actually based in Newcastle. So next season's time where Derby will be Sunderland and Middlesbrough instead of Sunderland and Newcastle.
The game today features Sunderland play Liverpool. This is the Sunderland team for you today. Costel Pantelimon plays in goal. Jonathan Roberge starts, despite looking shaky in recent
games. It'd be weird to not even be playing them in FIFA. The only time I'll come up against Newcastle is if I draw them in the cups or they come up in the game.
And off for Bale. And that is not lucky by any means. He knew exactly where we wanted
to go. So until they do come back up, it'll be a
great news for Liverpool. They are
we're not playing them for a while. I mean, I'm sure I'll come up against them in the cups eventually.
Billy Jones.
I mean, they're probably still, depending on how the drawing goes. So, I'll still get a chance to play against them, but not as regularly as normal. It's a bit sad. I'm a bit pissed off that the fact that he took 4 points from Liverpool and couldn't stay up. Assholes.
Testing it out. The goalkeeper comes out with a punch. He's got his shot off now.
Ah, you got me, Kane. How the hell did that happen? Why don't I have handballs on? That clearly struck his hand.
The corner has led to that effort at goal, which wasn't far away.
Thank you, Neymar. Thank you for wasting that chance. It wasn't totally necessary that I needed to score that. Nah, don't worry about it.
Trying to stretch the opposition using the wider areas here. There's going to be a throw in after that tackle. Taken quickly. That's offside.
Offside, I'll take that. Offside against Falson. I'm not sure how to pronounce his name. I don't recognize him either. Maybe he's a region or a player I just haven't heard of because he doesn't play in the league I normally watch. He's definitely not a Premier League player. Not even a yellow card for that! Wait, is that the same guy? No, they just have the same haircut. It's weird. I would put Ronaldo on this, but it's more of a crossing scenario than a scoring scenario. It's actually how Sunderland got their first goal against Everton. A free kick taken by the man who just threw the ball in, Patrick Van Aanholt. In fact, all of Sunderland's goals were defended. Van Aanholt and two from Kone. It's a bit weird that the Sunderland Everton game had two goals from Kone, and it wasn't Aruna Kone, it was a defender named Kone who played for Sunderland. So this, I don't even think the striker played. I haven't seen him in a while. I can't remember the last time he played. Maybe he's injured. I don't know.
The shot's on! Wonderful finish!
I do know it's 2-0, thank you. Who that fantastic strike from Philippe Coutinho.
To find the left corner.
Terrible kick out from Pantelimon. Who doesn't even play for Sunderland anymore.
Just widen the margin here to 2-0.
Although you could... Mark?
Lee Catamon.
They haven't really needed him, because... Because your man's been solid.
Strong, fair challenge.
Oh, crap, why is his name escaping me? Mignon. Mignon. No, that's Mignon. I'm thinking.
That's a fine tackle.
No. The guy who. The ex Arsenal keeper. I can't think of his name. Why can't I think of his name? I know it starts with an M.
Marco Royce.
I'm sure someone will comment below. Well, please do. I don't know why it's escaping me, but it is. There you go. I can't think of a player's name. What a surprise. Tino. Royce. I'll take a corner.
Stop the cross like that. That's a corner. First goal, well worth another viewing. Coutinho.
Ronaldo! CR7 does it again. Still haven't given them the number 7 number. I'll do it after I end the video. Or maybe I'll do it just before I end the video, so I don't forget. Because normally after I end the video, I save and then I turn it off. So I could easily forget to do that.
And in goes the cross.
A bit hard to actually accurately call Ronaldo CR7. He's not number 7. And CR14 just doesn't sound right. Come on, referee! Quates, former Liverpool defender. What a dirty bastard. Mignone! I remembered it. Vito Mignone.
Is that we've got one team in very good form and another.
It finally kicked. There we go. That's the name of the keeper. And he's been doing pretty well. Oh, I'd say. I mean,
still on the attack, and they've got
in terms of keep making great saves. He didn't make great saves against Liverpool. And chances Everton did get him. He made them look like nothing.
Sorry we had to cut short Alan McAnally then.
Maybe getting rid of Pantelimon was the right choice for Sunderland. Would they have stayed up if they had kept him? Who knows?
On to Ronaldo. Oh, he's got away from him. He's fouled by Ronaldo.
What? How is that a foul on him? If anything, that should be a drop ball.
Sports, the presentation of the Barclays Premier League.
What a little horse. Crap. Come on! Are you freaking serious? Of course! Fuck you, referee. Fuck you. I get fouled, nothing given. should have been a penalty. He make a smaller foul, and they get a free kick. What a load of fucking shit. Neymar, that header was much better than your earlier attempts. Neymar, it wasn't going in, but it's on the corner, so. Oh, bonus! Corner from nothing. Ronaldo, the deflection gets us another corner. You have to wonder where it would have went had it not taken a deflection.
Royce!
Off the freaking post again! It's the second match in a row I've hit the post. It's from a great looking strike. I think Emery Chan's was probably better. In terms of appeal to the shot. Not to dismiss anything from Royce's attempt.
Patrick Van Aanholt. Nathaniel
Klein. Really? 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 Why would I want to pass it to the side? Fuck you, game. I wanted to play an over-the-top pass. Klein, over to the side. Please don't. That has to be a yellow. Come on, referee. Quates. Well, right, that should be a second yellow, and he should be taking an early shower, but I'll take it being his own a yellow. It's gonna be CR7, obviously. Go on, Cristiano! Damn it! I'm never gonna score another free kick, am I?
Dos Santos. Giovanni Dos Santos. Free kick given by the referee, and the defending team might be in
force.
Might regret conceding this.
The man used to stand on the line. Hey, they blew it wide anyway. I almost put Nathaniel Klein on the line. Great, he player, and exactly the tallest.
From Gareth Bale. Neymar!
Hey, we got 4th in the game. Bale, who scored the first, has assisted the 4th and final goal. That is what I call therapeutic victory. Healing is done. Ha! Just like that, I feel much better after the last. 2 very convincing wins. And this might be worse. Might be better, actually.
Cristiano Ronaldo.
Thinking opposition's playing you. Ronaldo's offside. It doesn't matter, there's the full time whistle. 4-0 it ends. I don't suppose Chelsea dropped points. Probably not. I'm gonna have to wait until I play them. Although, Villa have been playing for the last couple of seasons, and I think they're in 5th. Come on. I'm playing in Copenhagen in the next game. next episode in my Champions League group. Please let Chelsea drop points against Villa, please. Yes! They lost! Thank you, Aston Villa! Thank you, Aston Villa, you legends! That is brilliant! I'm back to where I'm supposed to be, top of the table, and it's thanks to Aston Villa. Would you believe it? Oh, that's brilliant. And to celebrate, there you go, Cristiano. There you go, 7. Oh, I thought Brito had emailed me in complaint. He's like, whoa, what's this fucking shit? Oh, it is good. That's a great way to end the episode. Definitely good. All this thank you, Villa. Ah, it is thank you, Miller, because they put me back at the top of the league with a win over Chelsea. If I knew any Aston Villa fans and I told them they'd beaten Chelsea, they'd be like, wait, what? It's unfortunate, I don't know any Aston Villa fans. Ah, well, maybe there are some in the comments. If there are any Villa fans in the comments, thanks. Thanks, your team did me a great service. As I'm back where I belong, top of the pyramid. So smash the like button for me returning to the top of the pyramid. Hey table, well, make sure you hit the subscribe button. And if you are new to the channel, you enjoy the content. And then until next time, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace!